Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today video guys, we got a carbon pipe 6-inch standard wall. I'm gonna show you root skills, techniques, how to do on a carbon pipe. So for the gap, I like 532, loose 1/8. It all depends. Feather edge prep as usual, clean in and out, make sure your prep is good so you don't have any contamination, your puddle is going to be nice and smooth. So I like to use that weld gauge. It just measures the width of your gap, so 4 mil, that'll be ideally. So for the tack, I'll do the root tacks. I'm just going to put 2 root tacks on this one. The only difference is it's going to be 1 inch long, and if you put 1 inch long good solid root tack, the pipe is not going to move. The ones you set up and position and set up all the gap you like and everything, all the high low line up, that pipe is not going to move at all. As I said, minimum inch long root tacks, and I'm going to set up in 6G. The gap is a little bit wider on the bottom, and that's I did in purpose. Just gonna show you the overhead. I know lots of guys struggle the most with the overhead part, and I'll just show you a couple things, just the way how I a little bit position myself and how to do the root part. As I'm gonna put it's gonna hold the rod inside above that edge. As you can see, the wire, that filler rod is going to be above that edge. You can look through the gap from the top, or you just position yourself on the side. As I said, you can feed from the top, like back feed, or just place that filler rod a little bit more horizontally. And the same thing with the other side. If you don't use a left hand, you can do it like this. Pretty much the same thing. Freehand or walk the cup, whatever works better for you. You can even use a smaller nozzle that's gonna fit inside that bevel, so it'll be easier for you just to wiggle that cup inside a bevel. And as you can see here, so once I preheat both sides, make my connection, and that start point is most important. You just want to keep that rod, as I said, it's inside above that edge from the inside, and I'm just constant feed. It'll be easier. I mean, it all depends. Back feed is most recommended, especially when you're freehanding. But in a, if you're in a field and not much room above, you can feed it from the side. Same thing when you continue, you can always grind stop starts. And every time when I continue, I just preheat the start point. As soon as the root start getting liquid, then you add wire. As I said, it's a constant feed, still keeping my rod inside that edge. It's above that edge, and I'm just going up. As soon as I go one on the side, and now I got that root tack, I'm just gonna feather it out and try to do my tie-in, try to make a nice smooth connection, try to blend it in. Okay, and that's the good solid TIG root. What I like to do, you're accomplishing just to being consistent in feeding your rod. You have to have that constant feed. Try not to lose your connection when you doing root. Just to keep it on the edge of the puddle, and especially for the tie-ins here, guys, I'm gonna show you as well. Before I tie in, just like to pause on the side, add rod. I'm pretty much using a kind of dipping technique here. A little pause, a little bit when you make a tie-in here, and then just pass over it half inch or so, and then you can stop. Okay, now let's check it out. Okay. That's the root. It's a little bit heavy, which is pretty much what I like. If you watch my previous videos, I like a little bit heavier root, but the main thing is to have your root to be consistent and uniform all the way around. If you like heavy root, just try to keep it that way all the way around, so you don't have any much oscillation in uniformity or thickness of your root, which helps later for your hot pass, for any other passes after that. Feel it's not gonna give you any sag back, as I like to run hot on the sag back, especially on this part. For the hot pass and fill, I'm gonna do one pass, and that's gonna include hot pass and filter flush in one pass. So if you go with 332 rod and a little bit shallow on your root, you might experience a sag back, definitely. That's why that's like I said, that's why I like heavier root, so I'm not worried about any sag back. Okay, pretty much once like on the 9 o'clock, and then you go up to the top to 12, you want to pull out that rod. You don't have to keep it inside like on the bottom part, to be inside that edge, to be inside that pipe like above edge, and then when you go all the way up to 8, almost 9 o'clock, then you can pull it out and slowly start pulling it out all the way up to the top. You can also finish with a dipping technique or constant feed, like in this case it's kind of constant feed. So I lay wire wheel a little bit more hotter, and then you just go over it like a little bit faster, and this is the root pretty much consistent all the way around, and that's exactly what I like. As I said, I like heavier root, and now I'm gonna do hot pass. So for the root, guys, here I was running 115 amp. I got that remote set up. I'm using that Miller XMT. For this one, I got it's around 115, 120. It all depends. Depends from the machine, but depends from the environment and material and everything. But here for this one, I'm in a controlled environment, so not worry about any wind or porosity, stuff like that. As I said, I'm going one pass. It's filter flush right away, so I'm doing hot and fill. Probably usually take probably just two passes, but I'm gonna do it in one. Especially I'm gonna just to show you the way how it there's no any sag back. Even if it is, it's so minimal because the heavy root is, you not even notice. It's not gonna affect your any quality of your weld. And I mean, you can do that for standard weld. If it's a SCAD 80 and a higher, definitely you wanna go hot pass and then one pass fill, and fill passes. It'll be a little bit harder to do it one pass on a heavier wall. But on a standard wall, there's no problems. So for this one, it's 150 amps for this hot pass and filter flush. I'm going slow. I'm melting that rod. I'm making sure everything is nice and covered. You don't have to rush too much. It's all good. So this is how it looks. It's filter flush. It's now ready for a cap. It's not too hot. I mean, you can always wait a little bit, you know, for your pipe to cool down. Sometimes it's way better to wait to cool down, not start right away for your cap. I'm just gonna walk the cap, stretch the paddle side to side. No rush, take your time. This is still 1/8 for the cap. I'm using the same amperage I was using for a hot pass and that filter flash, 150. So no rush. Stick out of my tungsten is it's always pretty much the 10-15 mil stick out. Make sure it's always sharp. It'll be easier to control your paddle. Stretch, it's like a pen. It's like a pencil. When you sharpen your pencil and then you just play with your paddle. Pretty much that filler rod is right in the middle. You push as needed in the paddle just to have that the same uniform, the same build up all the way around. And that's it pretty much. This is the cap, one side. I'm just gonna finish the other side. Always start on the bottom. I go always place my nozzle like maybe inch from where I started. And start adding rod right away. And just stretch that paddle, nice and easy, cover side to side motion. Try to maintain the same equal steps. That's gonna make your cap look nice and smooth. Shows a lot, you know, just tells a lot about the welder. When they see your cap and they see your root, I'm gonna tell you about your consistency, about how focused you are. You have a good control. It tells a lot. It's like a signature. And that's what it is pretty much. Every weld is a signature. Sometimes, I don't know if you guys, depends who you're working with, you know, you got lots of experienced welders out there. As soon as you see the weld, you know who welded that pipe. And that's it pretty much. That's how the weld should look like. Nice and uniform, clean. Clean and always after each pass, it'll be easier for you. You don't have any impurities on the weld. That's being contracted from the side, from the pipe, all that dirt, oil, grease, whatever you got. And that's it. As I said, thanks for your support, guys. Hope you like it. Hope you learn something new. And remember, you gotta burn to learn, guys. There's no other way around. Take care and see you in the next one, guys. Play safe.